Hello, it's my pleasure to give this presentation about Lattice-based group encryption with the full dynamicity and message filter policy. It's a joint work by Jing Pan, Xiaofeng Chen, Fangguo Zhang, and Willy, Susilo. In this talk, beginning with a short background of group encryption, we introduce the fully dynamic group encryption primitive, then show the ideas and technologies we use here. Finally, we make a conclusion for this work. Group encryption is a fundamental anonymity primitive analog of group signature. It consists of these algorithms. By containing valid recipient for specific subtest within a group of certified users, while keeping traceability to anonymous behavior, it provides the confidentiality and anonymity and traceability. Since its first birth, the group encryption has found a wide of applications in the real estate world, such as trusted third parties, oblivious retrieval storage systems, hierarchical global signatures, and encrypted mass filtering. All the applications show its essential goal is to hide valid subtest recipients within a certified group while keeping traceability to anonymous behavior. We can show group encryption as in the following figure. So it involves five parties: a group manager who manages the group, an opening authority who anonymizes the subtest when a dispute is occasion, a sender, a verifier, and users. According to the KDE model, the group encryption scheme can be constructed from a secure digital signature, a CCA2 public anonymous public key encryption, zero knowledge argument. When a sender wants to securely transmit a witness complying to relationship R to a member belonging to a group, it encrypts the witness and the user public key and encrypts the recipient's identity under the open authority public key, then generate a zero knowledge argument to demonstrate that the subtest is well formed and can be correctly decrypted by the member belonging to a group. Now we review the research line of group encryption. The concept was first introduced by KTY in 2007, where they provided the formalized definition and a modular design. Later, by reducing the number of runs, the CL scheme was proposed. It was a scheme with no interactive zero knowledge in the standard model. To stress the secrets, the IPv scheme was proposed. It was free of subliminal channels. After that, a more practical scheme was proposed of weak assumptions. Similar to traceable signatures, a traceable scheme was proposed. However, we argue that all these schemes were constructed of traditional number-theoretic assumptions and they would be fragile in the sense of quantum computing. To change this situation, the first quantum resistance scheme was proposed by Lippert from Lattice. Recently, another post-quantum scheme was proposed over coding theory. It also features the field dynamicity and message filter policies. It promotes the development of group encryption, especially in the age of encrypted image filtering. We argue that these two later schemes are quantum resistant. However, except the last scheme, all the schemes are lack of full dynamicity and message filter policies, which limits applications in the age of encrypted image filtering. Moreover, the SS scheme has these cons. It is suffering from obscure security experiments in extreme efficiency and weaker security. Thus, we may ask a question. Can we propose a lattice-based scheme with fraud dynamicity and spotty message filter policies while replacing the existing coins? Our answer to this question is positive. In this work, our contributions are we reformulate the model and security requirements of a fully dynamic group encryption, instead of directly adapted from that of fully dynamic group signatures, we upgrade it from KDL model by adding appropriate ingredients, and it is essentially equal to, but more succinct and understandable than the currently existing model. Then we provide the generic and efficient zero knowledge proofs for zero binary vectors and prohibited messages filter policies in the Lattice CD. Both of them are used for abstraction. Finally, we construct the first Lattice-based fully dynamic group encryption with spotty message filter policies. The scheme is well followed our model and is also possessing enhanced efficiency in the standard model. Now we introduce the fully dynamic group encryption primitive. The goal of this primitive is to allow users to join or leave the group in the ease. To achieve this function, motivated by the design of fully dynamic group signatures, we upgrade it from the KDL model by introduce time factor and a group update algorithm. This fresh primitive consists of these fellows. The first setup is the user to generate the public parameters. Given the public parameters, the group manager, the opening authority, and the users run the key generation algorithm to generate the key paths respectively. After that, the user and the group manager run an interactive protocol to introduce the user into the group. When the protocol ends successfully, it generates a certificate to show that the user's membership is certified by the group manager. When a user wants to leave the group, the group manager runs this algorithm to remove the user and issue the latest group information. For encryption, the sender runs this algorithm to simple a statement witness pair complying to relationship R. Then the sender encrypts the witness and the user public key with the group information information R. Once the recipient receives the subtext, it runs this algorithm to recover the witness. Also, when a dispute is occasioned, the opening authority opens this subtext via this algorithm. Finally, the sender performs a zero knowledge argument to convince the verifier that the subtext is a well formed group encryption whose plain text is compliant R. Subsequently, the security requirements are the message secrets, the anonymity, and the soundness. The message secrets ask that it is hard to distinguish genuine subtext and random subtext generated at the same epoch. Well, the whole system, except the honest recipient, is under the control of the adversary. The anonymity asks that it is hard to distinguish which public key of two chosen recipient is used to generate safe text at epoch time. Well, the whole system except the two chosen recipients and the opening authority is under the control of the adversary. The scientists ask that it is hard to generate a convincing group encryption subtext generated at epoch time that is able to be finally traced back to an unidentified group member or invalid public key. Where the group manager is honest and the opening authority is partially corrupted. Our basic idea is like this. According to the module design presented by KTY, a group encryption scheme can be constructed from a secure digital signature, a CCA2 key provides public key, and a zero knowledge argument. in our design. Some motivation is taken to achieve the for dynamicity. We utilize an update accumulator to fully certify group membership. Since the GPU dual encryption is used to encrypt witness and recipient identity. Finally, the young afterwards, the knowledge argument is used to demonstrate the validity of a subtest. By these designs, we achieve the for dynamicity and a dense key space, which runs into a scheme with efficiency. Now we present our design idea. Given the public parameters, the group manager, the opening authority, and the users generate their key paths respectively. Then the group manager builds a lattice-based language tree of n size, leaves with initial zero values. When a user wants to join the group, it sends his public key to the group manager. The group manager checks its collision with the previous public keys, and if not, has it into binary vector p. Then replace zero value by p while advancing the counter. All these operations can be shown in the following figure. At the iterator of the protocol, the group manager builds a tree like this. When a user with index 011 wants to join the group, the group manager replace the initial value by his public key's hashed value. And for any another junior group application, the group manager handles it similarly. This is the group update operation. When a user wants to leave the group, the group manager sets the leave value associated to revoked user as zero, then update the MAC tree by recomputing the node values on the path from the specific nodes to the root. This process can be simply shown in the following figure. When a user with index 011 wants to leave the group manager sets its leave value as zero, then updates the tree along the path consisting of yellow nodes from the bottom to the root. This is the encryption process. The sender samples a witness W according to some messaging filter policy, then encrypts the witness W under the user public key and encrypts the position value under the opening authority's public key. In this encryption, to achieve CCA security, the nonlinear paradigm is also utilized. Finally, the sender performs a zero knowledge argument to demonstrate that the subtest is holding the following. The user public key is certified and activated at epoch tau. The witness W is encrypted under public key, and the associated position value J is encrypted under the opening authority's public key. Finally, the witness W is compliant to the message filter policy. The performance of this work is like this. Here we take the 8-bit security level as an example. By the above result, our scheme is over 25 and 35 schemes in terms of function, efficiency, and security. Our efficiency advantage comes from the free trapdoor design and the usage of Yang et al.'s zero knowledge argument. Now we explain the main difficulty in this work. The difficulty is mainly reduced to perform zero knowledge for the active membership and witness property. In the sense of Yang et al.'s framework, let's first recall the Yang et al.'s framework. We describe it in the subscripted form. Well, M and Y are a public matrix and vector, and X is a secret vector. The flat body M is the set of three tuples of IGH, of which XH is equal to the product of X and XJ. It incorporates the short norm and the head matrix vector product relations. We now consider to prove that binary vector P is non-zero. Actually, under the two type, The relationship is easier to prove by painting a minus one diamond entrance and applying the decomposing extending permutation technologies. However, in the sense of Young Atwood framework, the method cannot be used. One may find able to act with the knowledge method for integral relationships, like the variable x in the interval alpha and beta is useful. However, the method is still evaluated. To address this problem, we consider the following subtraction. Let the variable x with index r be in the interval alpha and beta. Prove among which alpha g is less than xg. Interestingly, let alpha I be 0 and beta I be 1. Our problem is a special case. The difference between our problem and the Lattice-Based problem is 2 pro. Some variable among them satisfies an inequality. Actually, it is hard to prove this relationship one by one. Thus, we change our strategy. We equally transform it into a sum problem and prove the little one. Quickly, we sum xi and then prove that alpha is less than the sum of xi, where alpha is a fraction value. With taking alpha 1 to alpha n as input, our concrete solution is like this. Introduce a compository vector q, then prove q's norm is bounded. Immediately, introduce a compository vector q such that the sum of p and q is equal to a vector, with each entry being 1. Then prove its I1 norm is not greater than n minus 1. Further, using the technologies for improve inequality relationship in the Lattice-Based, we can transform it into the final solution, where G is a public matrix dependent on n minus 1. This provides our solution. Now we start our proofs for the message filter policies. There are two common policies in Kuo's filtering. The first is the permissive type, and the second is prohibited type. The permissive type is defined as given E string SI and a secret string W. At least there is a string SI as a substring W. The prohibited type is similarly defined, given the same strings. For any substring Y over W, the Hamming distance between SI and Y is not less than d, where d is a consistent, fixed consistent. We note that the proof must in the lattice are known, especially under the Young Atwood framework. Moreover, the proof for permissive type is trivial and incorporated into the that of a prohibitive type. Thus, we only need to consider the proof for the prohibited type. The difficulty to this problem is first, how to express the substring relationship Y as a substring of W, then how to compute the XOR operation of binary vectors A and B in the sense of 10k modulus Q. Finally, how to handle the not less than relation. We note that the second point is basic but key. Accordingly, our solution is like, write the substring relationship as an equation, like yj equal to the product of bj and w, where bj is a public matrix. Then introduce the modulus transformation operation. Finally, use our fresh solution for non-zero p to deal with inequality. Our concrete solution is like this. Our starting point is for any bit xy, the XOR operation is equal to the later equation. We then generalize it into the sense of vectors like this. then it is used to write the desired relationship as this equation. Now, by setting yj as the product of bj and w, and after taking somewhat complicated computations, we obtain the final equation, where bj are public matrices and d is a public vector, whereas w and j are secret vectors. It means that when one wants to prove a vertex w is complying to prohibitive type, it only needs to prove that it satisfies such an equation. Please note that our solution for p not equal 0 and the message filter policy are also compatible with the store type. Now we make a conclusion for this work. We reformulate the fully dynamic group encryption with more succinct and understandable security requirements, then provide the generic and efficient zero knowledge proofs for the zero binary vector and prohibitive message filter policies in the Lattice city, both of which are used for orchestration. Finally, we propose the first Lattice-based fully dynamic group equation with supporting message filter policies. It is also possessing enhanced efficiency in the standard model. That's all. Thanks for your attention.